Yep. Flying by the seat of our pants today.
Gonna need those hot takes. Hot and ready.
Yeah, I got absolutely no notes. I don't know what we're gonna talk about.
All right, just going to shoot from the cuff today. All right, I like it. Mm-hmm. Some of our best work.
Yeah, or worst.
Or worst.
Mm-hmm.
All right. All right, we go. 3, 2, 1. Welcome back to the Nightcap, everybody. It's been a second. How's everybody
Welcome
doing?
Back, guys, to another very special episode of sports episode of the Nightcap. And, well, look at here. It looks like a Bang Bang Niner gang went back to hiding after that devastating loss to hated rival.
Just going for it, huh? Right?
Absolutely. All right, absolutely. Well, but I will give you props, though. You're the only Niner fan that had cojones to come back on air.
Well, before we get into it real quick, we're going to touch on that in a second. If this is your first time watching the show, guys, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. Do us a favor. Also, feel free to leave a comment below. Let us know what you think. And also, of course, if you guys are so interested, I'll go ahead and put up our Instagram handle right now as well. So you can find us there. And feel free to follow us there. You know, smash the heart button over there as well. But as Al's alluding to, you know, now we're back down to two, all right? Because it was after a tough loss. We took last week off, but, you know, that championship game, 49ers at Rams.
Had to lick your wounds. I was like, hey, I was ready to go. I was like, hey, guys, we got to do another episode. And they were like, oh, you know, there's really nothing to talk about. I'm like, oh, is there? There's not? There's not. Okay.
Nothing to talk about in my book, all right? It just was what it was. It is what it is, right?
You guys just ran out of juice. You know, against a team that you supposedly owned, but apparently didn't own when it mattered. Am I right, Steve, or am I right?
Here's the thing: is you're wrong. Okay, because as far as I'm concerned, we still own them. All right, we packed out SoFi. All right, came down to the last minute in the game. All right, so look it. I can't help it. We were banged up. All right, we had a battle. Those last few weeks, right? So even for the last few weeks of the season, playoffs started early for us.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, you know, it is what it is. A very talented Rams team. Cooper Kupp was a real
King star, Cup,
right?
Triple crown, you know, winner.
It's true. And that Jimmy G magic, you know, he is who we thought he was. That's all I got to say.
I'm just going to say, man, you guys better be careful what you wish for, because I know you guys were like ready to crucify that guy. Literally kick him in the ass on the way out the door. But be careful what you wish for, because you never know if Trey Lance is the answer or if he's going to be ready next year. So I don't know, man. I don't know. I don't know what your thoughts on that is, being that,
you know, I'll say this right now, because unlike some of the other Niner fans, you know, I don't hate Jimmy G. Thanks for the memories, because let's be real. Before he showed up, we were garbage. All right.
Absolutely.
We were a real dumpster fire.
Absolutely. I was razzing you every season.
He gave its legitimacy. So for as much hate as he gets, you know, and he's got his flaws. We all know him, right? Mm-hmm. The man can't throw the ball away to save his life. Can't really throw a pass 35 yards.
Gunslinger.
You know, sometimes he throws. I don't know if the guy's even looking. He just chucks it up there.
He's like, Debo's going to be somewhere down
exactly.
there.
Exactly. Debo or George Kittle is going to catch this. He's going to chuck it between the hashes. See what happens. You know?
Yeah, where do you think he's going to end up?
Yeah, that's a great question. I'll tell you what I hope, and I hope Matt's watching at home.
No,
Tampa Bay, maybe a little trade action, a little tradey trade. Bring Tommy the GOAT back home.
So you really think that since Tom Brady just said that he might have the itch to Jesus Christ, he just retired less than a week ago.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
And now, and then a little clip say, oh, you know, maybe you never know. And now you got Niner fans are all, we got to get Tom Brady. He wants to come back home. I'm like, Jesus Christ, put your pants back on. All right? Put your pants back on, guys.
Look it, man. Tom Brady, much like me, he's a competitor. All right? He lives, he drives for that competition. And, you know, mm-hmm. I think he could be motivated again if he came back home just to win one here, you know? Mm-hmm. I think he had to prove something when he went to Tampa that he could do it without Bill. He proved it. You got nothing more to prove there. But come back home, you know, win one for your childhood team. I think that could be a motivating factor for this guy. And look, he's still got in the tank. I mean, the guy,
he's
slowed down on the field.
Mm-hmm.
And so what? Trey Lance gets to sit, you know, one more year. Aaron Rodgers sat, 3 years before he even got on the field?
I think it was more than that, wasn't it?
What's the big deal? You know what I'm saying?
So but here's the thing. Bucks will not trade away his rights just for Jimmy G alone.
They might. So, I mean, if they get Jimmy G, right? They might. You're right. They might need something else. But at the same time, it's like you get, at least you get something for Brady retiring, right? Because he's, you know, his mind's like, I either stay retired or you trade me and you get something for nothing. So, you know, that could be enticing too. You never know.
No, Brady's staying retired. I mean, he had that long 8-page Instagram post about, like, you know,
audios. No press conference, but no press conference. You notice
no that? Press conference, but I did read that, you know, like, because like Patriots fans were all up in arms. Hey, how come he didn't fucking thank us? Hey. So, but then what I read was like, he's saving that because he wants to sign like a 1-day contract with the Patriots to retire, officially retire a Patriot. So good on Tommy Boy if he does that.
We'll see. But we'll see about that. I mean, it could happen, but I don't know. We'll see. You know, he was coming off that loss. That was a tough loss. And, you know, these playoff losses, they sting out. All right. I don't know much about that. You just got
Matt Stafford and Cooper Kupp sent him to retirement.
So, you know, I think now that he's starting to chill out, you know, he's going to look around, look at his beautiful wife, walk around his big, beautiful house. But he's going to say, you know, what am I doing? What am I doing? What am I going to do here? You know, barbecue all day? What am I going to do? Play PlayStation?
I'm sure he has different ventures. Yeah. Sure, he has different ventures to go through.
I don't know. I don't know, man. We'll see. We'll see. Well, you know, that's what I'm hoping. That's what I'm thinking. Wishful thinking, of course. That's all my ideas. Wishes. Wishes in the ether, right?
Throwing it out
there. Let's touch on that other game, though. The Bengals at the Chiefs.
Whew.
Man, that was surprising, man. I honestly, God, I really thought the Chiefs were the best team. I kind of still do, to be perfectly honest.
Man.
But, man. Bengals, a team of destiny?
It's almost seeming like they're the team of destiny. I mean, I was texting you guys, like, that thing was over. I was congratulating, you know, our friend Gabe, shout out to Universal stuff. And I was like, hey, congrats on the Chiefs making the Super Bowl again. And I told you, I'm taking a nap, guys, and I'm going to the gym. Woke up from my nap. It was tied in the fourth quarter. I'm like, hell yeah, let's do this.
Yep. Exactly. Man, and just Burrow and Chase, man, they got some magic on them. You know, they're just such a fun combo. And the Chiefs, I'm not really quite sure what happened. They just kind of like fall apart at the end. They were looking solid.
At the very end, they went back to being the Chiefs where they were just looking for the home run. And instead of like what they were doing throughout the tail end of the season, plus the playoffs, plus even the beginning of this game, you know, not dink and dunk, but, you know, obviously you take what they give you. But then again, after that, Patrick Mahomes, old Kermit the Frog, went back to trying to hit home runs. Yeah. And it didn't work. It didn't work this time. There was no magic this time.
Yeah, it was surprising. I mean, I guess it wasn't totally surprising. We know they beat them earlier in the year. And it was close. But I really thought that they were going to dial it in. They looked so good against the Bills. So it was a little bit for me, but maybe I'm underestimating these Bengals, but let's go ahead and transition a little bit. There's been a few offseason moves. And most notably, Las Vegas Raiders got a new head coach, buddy. Oh, buddy.
Ooh, man, I really wanted to talk about this last week because that's when I was really at my peak of like, what am I going to say? Like, well, how am I going to take this? But obviously not my first choice. Obviously, my first choice was Dodds for GM. And Jim Harbaugh coming home to the Raiders. But from what I'm hearing, man, like he didn't really prepare for any interviews or anything. Like they were like, oh, Vikings are going to hire him. He walked in like he owned the joint, didn't have any, you know, good answers to the hard questions. And they're like, okay, never mind. We're just going to go with right.
Maybe he was just trying to get that paycheck from Michigan and just trying to, you know,
possibly. But when I heard it was like Josh McDaniel and Ziegler, I was just like, let me think about this. Because I didn't want to be like, you know, the typical Raider fan. Oh, fuck the Patriots and fuck those putos, you know. But I had to settle down. I was like, look, and what really helped myself and I think a lot of the Raider Nation was that press conference, the introductory press conference with both Ziegler and Josh McDaniels. Josh McDaniels showed humility because, you know, he fucking stunk with the Donkeys, with the Broncos. I'm like, guess what, guys? That was 13 fucking years ago.
Right.
Like anyone in the Raider Nation, were you guys the same person 13 years ago? Yeah. I'm not even the same person I was 2 years ago.
You could change. I can change.
Everybody can change. And he but he touched on that. He was like, look, guys, I failed that because I failed in building relationship with players and I didn't know how to do that. And, you know, when given, like, if I ever had the opportunity to become a head coach again, you know, I would have learned from that. And guys, I'm pretty sure he learned from that. He's been with the most successful franchise in the last two decades for like over a decade now. And that man, that guy Ziggler, bro, that guy is slick. He's like Robert De Niro in Casino slick. Like he looked, he came in that press conference, looked like he's ready to crush the draft. All right. And they had answers to all the questions. Mm-hmm. And what about Carr? What's going to happen with Carr? Well, they said, well, Josh McDaniels was like, look, I took this job because of Carr. I already talked to him. I want to build around him and all that good stuff. Right. And he had all the weapons.
Is that a good move? Is that a smart move?
Yeah. Well, here's the thing. Much like you got the Niners with Jimmy G, I talk a lot of shit on Carr.
I noticed that. I'm sorry.
But again, if he ever left, I would probably be like, well, shit, now we're really fucked, you know? So, So I'm willing to give him the benefit of the doubt. And then, you know, it was, you know, Ziggler slick move. Like, what about Carr? You know, the extension and all that. He's like, look, we want to get to know Carr, you know, how he works, how we work, and bada bing. All right. So
Are you sure he's not Robert De Niro for Casino?
Did he really? He does seem like Robert De Niro in Casino. And Mark Davis also said, like, look, everyone's expecting us to go, you know, the Raider, you know, Raider roots and hire somebody else with ties to the Raiders, you know, wink, wink, Jim Harbaugh. But I've had my eyes on the Patriots like for a very long time with obvious reasons. They're the most successful franchise in two decades.
Right.
And so he's like, and now the feeling is that, man, these guys are professionals. They're not just like, you know, when Chucky came with like Mike Mayock, who I still really like Mike Mayock, where they were like just hucking it up, like in the press conference, you know, like, hey, you know, just win, baby, you know, and all that. And, you know, emails aside. And but this one, it was like so professional. You felt like it was different. Like, and they're bringing in like all these great people. They hired like an assistant GM. They made a special position just to hire an assistant GM from the Bears. Oh, God, Champ Kelly, I want to say his name is. Like, he was highly touted, too. And, man, these guys, and they're just bringing professionals after professionals. Then the DC from Graham from the Giants. I know what you're saying. Giants fucking suck. They gave up so many points. But it wasn't his goddamn fault. Like, they had nobody. So, but this guy, though, everyone's, like, touting this. Like, this guy's not going to stay long because they said he's going to be a head coach like relatively soon. So I'm like, all right, well, shit, bring him on. I don't give a fuck where we got him for like two seasons or something. Mm-hmm. They call him Black Picasso.
Why is that?
I don't know. Like, they just call him a Black Picasso. So
I want to ask, but I don't know if it's politically correct. So I'm just going to keep my mouth shut.
Keep your mouth shut. And by the way, I stand with Joe Rogan, by the way. Just want to throw that out.
By the way, Joe, if you want to have a song, we're not afraid.
We're not afraid. If you want to come on to the nightcap, we will definitely give you a platform to voice your opinions and
we'll give you our whole audience. But go ahead, just
our whole 71 subscribers. You know,
God bless each and every one of them. That's all I gotta say.
I love each and every one of you guys, mom, dad, and everybody else.
Theo, I really appreciate it. Now smash that like button. All right.
But yeah, but in closing, man, it definitely feels like,
man, it's basically all champagne and roses over there. So you guys are just,
I'm popping the champagne already.
Ready for Valentine's Day. Y'all kissy kissy right now.
But I'm just saying, like, you know, Super Bowl is going to be in Vegas in 2024.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't we just keep the party going with all these home teams going to Super Bowl?
Oh, wow. You know what I'm saying? Here we go. Now we're talking. That's the all I know. Right. All right. Well, let's transition some other offseason moves. Man, what do you think about this Kyler Murray stuff, scrubbing his account and all this? Big old tantrum? What's going on here?
I don't know. I don't know what the heck's going on there, but it's always suspect when a player does that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he doesn't do that because he's happy with the team.
Yeah, here's the thing. These Zoomers, these Gen Zs, like, you know, the social media, that's everything to them. That's basically your social security card. So if you're scrubbing 100%, you're changing your, you know, your Instagram, right? So that's a big deal. You're sending a message, right?
Because another former Arizona Cardinal did the same thing, Patrick Peterson, and he left. Yeah, and he left right shortly thereafter when he did that.
Yep.
But then again, they still have the rights to Kyler Murray for, I believe, two more seasons. Pups, you want to correct me on that? And so he's not really going anywhere unless he really throws a hissy fit. I'm going to hold out or whatever the heck players can do now to try to force their hand. But then again, I don't think he'll do that because, you know, he seems like a stand-up dude. Maybe this is more of a shout out to, you know, the front office saying like, hey, we got to be better. You got to, you know, do something more. I don't know what more they could do. They gave him like, you know, a lot of pieces already. So,
yeah, they really did. I mean, the main thing he needs is just a healthy D Hop. I mean, that's really it. I mean,
absolutely. If DeAndre Hopkins was healthy and playing, maybe that Rams game would have been a lot different. Although they got their fucking ass kicked. Like that was surprising.
So well, he's their security blanket, especially on third down. I mean, you just toss to that guy. He's amazing. He pulls it down. I don't know how he does it, but all right. Not too much other stuff I want to touch on because honestly, I'm not super detailed. I don't want to talk about the Flores stuff. But one thing I will say, just as a Niner fan, Mike McDaniel going to the Dolphins. Good luck, guys. That's all I got to say. Now, I'm not saying he's a bad coach, but he never struck me as head coach material. I'll just say that.
He's a smart guy, though.
Smart guy, a Yale man, you know. But, you know, as far as the leader of men, I'll be curious to see how it works out. And, you know, we all know that the 49ers, it's Kyle's offense. You know what I mean? And Kyle's calling the plays.
Right.
So I don't know if he's just a, you know, if McDaniel is just a brilliant play designer or what exactly traits he's bringing to the table in Miami. But I think, like I said, good luck. I don't wish any ill towards him. I have a good friend, Chris, if you're watching, you know, go fans. Hopefully it works out for you guys. But I definitely wouldn't bet money on it. So we'll see how that works out.
He must have crushed that interview because
he must have, right?
He must have had like some sort of wizardry that he planned on doing with Tua. To just be like, you know what, this is our guy. This multiracial man is our guy. Yeah, that was shocking to me. I was like,
shocking to everybody. I still want to see the 23andMe. That's all I'm saying. Okay, like, I don't think it's an unreasonable request. But hey, whatever. It is what it is.
And speaking of good luck, man. Good luck to the Saints who ended up hiring Dennis Allen, their DC, to become the head coach. As a Raider fan, good luck with that. Well, obviously, he probably learned from his time with the Raiders, but man, good luck to him too, because he's going into a situation. Quarterback situation is, I don't even know. Their cap salary situation is fucked, guys. Look it up. It's the worst situation in the NFL. So I don't know. I don't know how he's going to do it, but you know, God bless.
As a Niner fan that's had many battles with the Saints, all I got to say to Sean Payton is good riddance.
Honestly, with Sean Payton,
bye, con Dios.
Don't say good riddance to him just yet. He might just take a year to recharge and then go to the Cowboys. You heard it here first.
Yeah,
going to the Cowboys.
Yeah, you know what? That's actually, I don't want to even think about that. That'd be a pain in the ass. The NFC, but all right, let's get to this big game. Am I allowed to say Super Bowl? Are we gonna get sued if we say Super Bowl?
The big game, the SB.
Okay, we'll call it the big game.
Fuck it. Super Bowl. Super Bowl. All right.
Hey, it's America. All right. America. Last time I checked. All right.
We're free.
We're free, right?
All right. We got a trucker convoy to DC. the Commanders.
I know.
Jesus.
Oh, Lord. All right. Let's talk about this game here. Bengals, Rams. You know, Gal said in the little intro, I'm shooting from the cuff right now. I'm just going to go with my heart on this game. I've been flip-flopping even before this game started. Like, who am I going with? You know, I'm thinking this. The Rams got this. The Bengals got that. You know what? I'm going to go 100% with my heart on this one. Bengals.
Ooh.
Bengals right now.
That's definitely hard Joe.
I've been underestimating him this whole time. Every game.
Same.
And he just keeps showing up and doing it. And I do like the Rams. I think they're a talented team. They got with Akers, much more dangerous team, much more balanced team. But I'm gonna go with my heart on this one, and I think Joe Burrow and Chase, they're gonna pull it out.
You definitely underestimated Joe Burrow because you traded him in fantasy, and see where that got you.
I didn't trade him actually. I kept him the whole year.
No,
I had him the whole year. Go back and look. But anyways, right. And Joe Burr drafted him too. He was my quarterback. I traded Joe Burr.
Joe Shiesty. But I'm going with this right here, the noggin, because on paper
with the Raiders. I was like, really?
The Raiders is gonna they're gonna come in like the Royal Rumble choice. Surprise. Like during halftime, it's like, holy shit, is that Max Crosby? He just got signed. But I'm going with the noggin here. On paper, the Rams should win. They're built to win now.
I agree.
They're built to win. They were built to go to
loaded roster.
Absolutely. And also my thinking is this, just because of the loaded roster, but also Aaron Donald's going to wreck that O-line. He's going to wreck it.
That's a good point.
They could triple team that guy. And with this O-line, he's still going to wreck the game. And he's just so hungry to win that ring. Like you saw him after he, you know, that very last play when he sacked, you know, Jimmy G, and he kind of like just tossed it and like the interception. He was like, I want that ring.
Yeah. What did he say? He's like, I got everything but that ring.
Right? Yeah. And then Von Miller's like hyped up because he's like, I want to play and get him his ring. And like I said, and then Matt Stafford, just throw it a Cooper Kupp. Cooper Kupp. Oh, man, what he's going to do to Eli Apple during Black History Month is going to be awful.
It's going to be racist.
It's going to be racist what Cooper Kupp's going to do to Eli Apple during the Super Bowl.
It's going to be 100% racist. They should cancel him.
So on paper, the Rams should win. But like you said, you got to throw in that Joe Shiesty, Joe Cool, like it factor.
He's got that that moxie, right?
Yeah, he got the turtleneck with the chain and the glasses, and he just doesn't give a fuck. And here's another thing too. They're so inexperienced and young in the Bengals team. They don't care. They haven't felt this pressure, so maybe they won't feel it.
Whereas like the opposite, Stafford, he looks like he's just dripping in pressure. Like he just showers in pressure. You know what I mean? Like he's like, yeah, they brought me here. They gave all this capital to get me. Like I gotta win. There's no excuses.
And here's the thing, pressure-wise, it's all on the Rams. Because, like I said, they were built to win now. They were built to win the Super Bowl. While the Bengals, 2 years ago, they were bottom of the barrel from last. The Bengals. Yeah. So there's no pressure on them. All the pressure's on the Rams. So maybe that might be another factor going into it. But in the end, talent has to win out. You know, and the Rams just have so much more talent. It's pretty much Ja'Marr Chase and Joe Shiesty versus the entire stack Rams squad. And that's too much to ask for. I get that they might, you know, they pulled it off. They pulled off some, you know, some magic tricks to get here. But I think that magic's going to run out against the Rams. The Rams are just as hungry, too. And like I said, the pressure is all on them to actually win this thing. Joe Burrow, he got years ahead. He probably has maybe one or two Super Bowl wins under him, like for his career. You know,
that's what you think, but you never know. But yeah, I hear you. Trust me. My brain says the Rams. But like I said, I've been counting this guy out every step of the way. And you know what? I'm not going to do it this time. I'm going to go with my heart. I'm going to go with Joe Burr. Okay. They're going to find a way to win. I don't know how. They'll shock the world again, right? Because, I mean, thinking about just this, like, again, I hope you guys go back, watch our other episodes if you guys have been following us. You know, the Bills. I thought the Bills were legit Super Bowl contenders. You know what I mean?
They deserve to be in the Super Bowl.
But like, these guys get knocked out, right? And that was a great balance team. The Chiefs, obviously. You talk about even the Titans. You know what I mean? Like, there's been a lot of these good teams. I mean, we just talked about nice, the Packers. These are the last two teams. So let's not underestimate them. You know what I mean? And,
yeah.
You know, they went through the Bengals went through a tough AFC to get to this point. Mm-hmm. And same thing with the Rams, too. But you know how like every year in the Super Bowl, there's always one team that starts off really slow and really tight. I think if the Bengals can get that lead early and say the Rams start off a little tight, you know,
it might be possible.
I could see him getting ahead and maybe getting control of the game and pulling it out. And vice versa, if the Rams get the lead, I don't think that's going to bother the Bengals because they've been playing from behind all year. I could see them easily just, like I said, they just seem so young, so loose. They're not going to be intimidated by the moment. They're playing with house money. And still coming out and putting up a good win. So we'll see.
I think it's going to be a banger of a game, though. And the halftime show I'm really hyped for, like unlike other normal, because man, that's my generation.
Okay, all right? Can we go off on a quick tangent? The Snoop by Death Row Records, the rights?
I don't know.
I saw that.
Yeah, I have to look into that. I saw a snippet of that. If he did do that, Fuck yeah.
That's pretty rad if it is true, but I don't want to digress too much. But yeah, you're right. We're going to have the halftime show for us.
Crip walking. I'll be crip walking through the halftime
show. You'll be sea walking in your living room, right? Singing along with the words, the explicit version, right? Yeah, that should be interesting. Man, how weird is it, though, just to say, again, we're on this tangent, that, like, you know, thinking about us growing up in the 90s and how, like, you know, gangster rap and all that was, like, such a, like, this...
Taboo,
like, hot topic. And fast forward so many years later, doing the halftime show. And everyone...
Halftime show.
My mom's going to be watching Snoop up there, you know what I mean? Singing along, like, ain't no fun, you know what I mean? Like, just get going at it, right?
These kids nowadays during the Super Bowl, they're going to find out how their parents really are once this halftime show starts. You know what I'm saying?
It's going to be a scene. It's going to be a scene. Mm-hmm. All the Gen Xers are going to be dancing. And yeah, it'll be fun. But, all right, man, so... I guess that's our picks, right? I'm going with the Bengals. You're going with the Rams.
Yep.
We'll see what happens. I'm not going to make a score prediction. I honestly
take the over. Take the over, though, everybody.
Hopefully. Some, you know, I hate to say it, but, you know, some Super Bowls are kind of stinker games. Now, a lot of times the best games are in those divisional championship rounds.
Oh, yeah. Can I just say we were blessed during the playoffs? I think this might have been the best playoff run that I could remember.
It was exciting. It was a lot of great games. Oh, my gosh. So many great games that came down to the wire, right?
Yeah. Almost all of them.
I guess a part of me is, like, preparing myself to be, like, this one to be a little
let down. Yeah,
a little bit, just because there's been so much great football. But a great football year for both of our teams, too. You know, I mean, let's be real. Like, the Raiders, you guys made it in there to the wild card round, right? And the Niners going all the way championship game. So, you know, it's a tough sport. There's only one person who gets to really celebrate at the end of the season. But still pretty fun year for both of us.
31 losers.
Yep, there it is. So let's kick it over to the people watching. Let us know what you guys think. Who do you guys have in the game? Who do you guys have to win? Are you going with your brain? Are you going with your heart on this one? And, you know, we'll catch up later and find out who wins. But, yeah, man, that's all I got for tonight. We went kind of longer than I thought here. Any closing thoughts before we wrap this up?
No, but I just know that it's just going to be a long off season because I'm ready to go with this new squad in the Raiders. So I'm ready to see what they put on the field.
I know. The NFL is kind of amazing with the way it's like, man, it's just it's all year long, right? Even the off season's got tons of stuff going on. I didn't even get to see much of the Senior Bowl stuff. So I'll probably watch the reruns on that.
Yeah. Same.
Trying to do my due diligence. And if you guys want to see more sports content, also leave that in the comments below. Listen,
absolutely.
If you guys are enjoying this stuff. You know, maybe we'll ride with you guys all off season two. And
definitely the draft special.
Yeah, exactly. All right. Well, that's all we got for tonight. Make sure you guys smash that like and subscribe button. Like I said, leave a comment below. And until next time, go Bengals.
Go Rams. And we'll see you guys for the Batman that's finally coming out after much delay.
Right on. Word.